Now that you have familiarized yourself with the Scratch programming environment in our first tutorial of this Programming in Scratch series, let's take a look at some of the things we can quickly and easily do in Scratch. In the second tutorial on Scratch, we'll design a new sprite, a flower, and then give it a few variations, which, as you will recall, are called costumes. We'll make use of this flower sprite in the next tutorial, making it sing, dance, and change colors as it moves across the stage. To get started with your design, first click the Paint New Sprite icon. We'll use the Filled Ellipse tool to create the first petal. Let's make it rather large to minimize jagged edges. You can adjust the size of any part of your design up or down by selecting it and using the Shrink and Grow tools. If you make a mistake, don't worry, you can always click the Undo button. Use the Stamp tool to make a second petal and place it next to the first one. Select the Stamp tool again and use it to make a copy of the two petals together. Place them to the side. Now use the Select tool to select the two new petals and use the Flip Horizontally tool to make them into a mirror image and combine the two sets. Select the Stamp tool and use it to make another copy of your design and put the copy to the side. Use the Flip Vertically tool to make the bottom half of your flower's petals and attach them to the top half. Now let's make the smaller inner petals for this flower, starting with one circle and then cloning it as before. We'll color the inner flower petals yellow by selecting this color with an eyedropper and then using the Bucket Fill tool to apply the color. Similarly, we'll color the larger petals red, and let's add a little contrast by filling the inside of the flower black. Now place the secondary petals inside the primaries, and our first flower is complete, except that it doesn't yet have the stem and the leaves. It'll be easier to make the stem if we first zoom our view all the way out. Now select the color green and use the Line tool to make a stem. Ellipse tool will come in handy again to make our leaves. We'll make them out of three parts. First the small, then the medium, and now the large. Let's now make another copy of our leaves with the Stamp tool and put it aside. Select one set of our leaves, rotate them to the right, and attach to the right stem stub. We'll need to select and move the flower closer to the center so that we can add a leaf on the left. Select the other set of leaves, rotate them to the left, and attach to the left stub. Now our first flower is really complete, stem, leaves, and all. We'll now want to create additional costumes for it, and we can easily do that by modifying the original. So let's make a copy. Name the original Red Right, and the copy Red Left. Edit. Flip the copy horizontally and click OK to save our second costume. Now when we switch between the red right and red left costumes, it'll look like the flower is dancing. Make copies of red right and red left. Call them blue right and blue left. Edit each of these costumes, filling the outer petals blue and clicking OK to complete. Now when we switch between the red right and blue right costumes, the flower will magically change colors. We'll follow the exact same process to create purple right and purple left, and then again for the two green versions of our flower. Once we're done with all these variations, we'll have a total of 8 costumes for our sprite actor, the flower. Let's call our new creation appropriately the flower and export it under the same name to a customs folder for later use. If we delete it from our work area now, we'll still be able to get it back the next time we want to use it. Voila! Here it is! This concludes our lesson on designing sprites in Scratch. In the next tutorial in the Scratch tutorial series, we will use the flower sprite you just created to make it sing and dance across the stage in your very first Scratch program. If you like the Scratch tutorial and would like to see more, please give it a thumbs up, add it to your favorites, subscribe to this channel, and come back here for additional tutorials on Scratch and other subjects.